Hello, it's your boy, Tranquil Comrade, and today I'm gonna give you a tour of my island. Let's get into it. Hello there, everyone. Right now, on Communism, it's 1:24 p.m. on Thursday, November 18th, 2021. I decided to set my clock to syncing with Wi-Fi for this video, but I have been time traveling a lot. I'm a dirty rotten time traveler, and who's gonna whoop my butt? Nobody. I don't have any big news to share with you all today, but I would like to touch on one seasonal topic. Maple leaves. Fall must be coming to an end. That's so sad. I do hope you all remember to enjoy this beautiful and vibrant time of year before winter sets in. I'm excited for winter. Now that I live in the north, I get to enjoy snow. It is possible to gather maple leaves with a net, you know. I did know that. I don't think I have any maple leaf DIYs. Maybe she'll give me one. Thank you so much for supporting us, Isabel. We love you. Yeah. That's what happens when you time travel a lot. You wake up with bedhead, and you have roaches all over your house. Okay, so this is my little garden. I have some gold flowers, not to flex, but these are my babies. I think I like pink roses more, surprisingly. This is Raymond's house. I just got him. I really like this little yard I made. It really matches his house. And then over here, it is really hard for me to hop. I don't know why. This is a hammock that I made with customizing. It is a Sada Shakur. And here's some like cute little wedding stuff that I put outside of my wife's house. I'm married, guys. Very recently. Congratulate me, please. I'm gonna show you the inside of my wife's house. It still feels very weird saying wife. I have a wife, guys. I killed the roaches for her. I'll protect the love of my life from these dirty, rotten roaches. It's crazy to me how they have hamsters in this game. Like, they just have regular animals. It's kind of like in Disney where they have, like, Goofy, which is, like, a sentient animal. And then the dog, which is just a regular dog. Oh, it has a cute little... I recently found out that you can play with this. And that your villagers will play with them if you give them one. And so I ordered two, and I'm gonna give them to my cat villagers, which may or may not be a hate crime. I kind of hate crimed, I think he's a leopard, my leopard villager, Leonardo, by giving him a kitty litter box. Which I'm sure is offensive to his culture, but I thought it was really funny. I should get him a pet bed too. Apparently your villagers will like sit in the pet bed, and I'm really excited for that. Like, I'm gonna put a pet bed out for my villagers, just so when they come over, they'll sit down in one. They have like a, they're doing like an office type setup. I gave them these, I gave my girlfriend, well, my wife, I gave my wife a lot of this furniture. Because I'm a saint. And also, I just like sending her little letters with gifts attached. And it's very simp behavior. But you know what? That's my wife. I'm allowed to simp. Anyway, I got this cute seasonal nuptial furniture for them. Marshall, you bitch. I'm gonna have to hit him. I guess I'll try talking to him. Do I look bored? Sorry, that's just how my face looks when I'm bored. Haha. That's cool and all, but I'm gonna need you to move, buddy. You know what they say about fishing, right? Well, please tell me, because I can't catch anything. Aw. Marshall is my sweet little baby. I actually kind of got him because Marshall reminds my wife of Bakugo from My Hero Academia. I'm gonna have to hit him with a net though. I'm sorry, he's not gonna move. Sir, move on. Oh, he's so cute. I'm sorry, but you gotta go, buddy. Okay, now. I guess you can't move them when they're doing a task, but you can push them around any other time. I'm gonna apologize. My bad, bro. Oh he doesn't want to talk to me. He doesn't want to talk about it. I'm sorry. Well, since you apologized, I'm willing to forget anything ever happened. Me too, buddy. Oh, what were we talking about again? He's so sweet. Oh, we've been through a lot together, haven't we? Even though we haven't known each other that long. Anyway, I think it's time I formally announce you as a member of my entourage. Okay. He really did get over it really fast. I wonder if Leonardo's home. I did the most decorating for his house because he's one of my originals and I love him. I got him a little pull-up bar. But he has like the crappy original home with like the basic flooring and the basic wallpaper. I got him this little coat, but yeah, look at this kitty litter box. I also gave my villagers a bunch of food before I realized that they will just put it in their home and not eat it. So he has two bowls of hearty ramen. Hey, anyone ever said you look like Maestro? Oh, it is you. Hey, next time you run off to some super secret fitness camp, don't forget me. Oh, I love you, Leonardo. Not that I need it. Check out my abs and my biceps. And actually, we can compare muscles later. Welcome back, Maestro. I feel bad when I leave them, but it's also really cute when you come back and they have these cute, like, they have new responses to you. I just feel like I've heard it all from them. And there we go. All right, Maestro, need something? What you up to? A gold nugget mining car. They don't usually give me new DIYs, so this is pretty exciting. I didn't even know this DIY existed. Yes, I want to make it. Give it to me. I'm really excited about like the revival of Animal Crossing because of the 2.0 update and the DLC. And like I just discovered the Animal Crossing community. I just discovered Animal Crossing Twitter, and it is booming, it is bussing. Everyone there is so chill and so fun, and I love it there. Like, somebody from Animal Crossing Twitter gave me literally a pocket full of bells. Like, literally a pocket full of bells, and it was all 99,000 bells. I have a photo. Maybe I'll put it up. Maybe I won't. Who knows? I have a lot of cute villagers. What's up, Julian? I hate that sweater. I guess I gave that to him because I thought it matched the color of his fur. Do unicorns have fur? Is that what you call it? I don't know. I'm just messing with you. You've been gone for so long. But seriously, you're not an actual ghost, right? Yeah, I have way too many smug villagers, and I think that's why I feel like I've heard it all from my villagers. Like, they just say the same exact things. Oop. They're all gonna call me out for being gone. Cherry calls me comrade. My island is, like, communism-themed a little bit. But it's also, like, I can't remember what the designer called these designs. Let me see. Moonwave. Okay, I got these designs from, like, the Reddit thread of Animal Crossing designs, like the Reddit community. And I got a lot of really cool stuff from there. Like these pink planks and this greenhouse. I have a greenhouse area I'll show you in a minute. But I really, this is not by the same person, but it looks similar, so I added it. I also got these pink eyebrows that are on my face. But yeah, I really love the Moonwave design, and if I find the creator, I will link them down below. But yeah, shout out to the Reddit Animal Crossing community for making my island beautiful. This took so long to put up. I'm really happy about how the little mantle covers look too, but I'll show you my little town square, put the pink planks up. I like this bench, I'm proud of this bench. This is my residence services area. I have a lot of flowers I'm trying to breed. I think I hear a balloon. Or maybe I'm tripping. I get distracted while I'm filming and I like miss a lot of balloons, and I'm sure that's gotta be frustrating to watch, cause I would be annoyed if I was watching somebody and they just missed all of the balloons. Let's see what I got. Reception chair. I don't know what that is. Ooh. Oh shit. Let's see what it looks like. That's kind of cute. I like it. I don't know if that's new, but I think it's gonna go cute right here. So I'm gonna put this place item. This is actually my little reception area. I think it's really cute. It makes me happy. Is it on? Yes. Okay, this is my reception area. Oh, I forgot to mention, I have these little DIY tables up around the island because it helps me when I'm like terraforming or building? Or just like when I need to build something, you know? I don't have to run all the way home. That's always a pain in the butt. I haven't been to Nick's Granny's today, so let's check it out. I'm really excited about all the 2.0 items. There's so many. There's literally 9,000 items. Hello. Welcome to Nook's Granny. Oh my gosh, it's green. I love it. I'm gonna buy it. Yes, thank you. Somebody let me catalog their stuff. If you don't know what that is, that means like, if you pick up an item, you can order it from your catalog at the little ABD system. So somebody let me catalog their stuff for like 2.0 items. Somebody let me catalog their 2.0 items, and I already have the evergreen ash because of that, but it is red. I know that you can now like go to like Cyrus to like up. I know you can go to Cyrus to customize all of your furniture now. Like if you have I think I hear a balloon. Or maybe it's just a sea. It might be the sea. Yeah, it's hard for me to hear the balloons because I'm also listening to myself and the gameplay, so. Oh, Flick's on my island. Normally she, like now she announces NPCs, which is really cool. I'm excited about that. So, it's weird that she didn't point out that Flick is on my island. This is my little pool. I want to customize these. I have one customized set out. But, I'm proud of this playground area. None of my villagers come up here. It's very sad. This is like the most unorganized tour ever. I have ADHD, so don't expect organization from me ever. I have a bunch of radios set out over here. I really hate the noise that this makes. I can't stand it, so I always have it off. I also hate the color that I got with my like Nook Miles stuff. Like I just got crappy colors. But this is like a little arcade area, like boardwalk type stuff. I have like a fortune telling area. It used to have like this cool little galaxy design, but I replaced it with like a different design because we used to have way fewer design slots. And I haven't fixed that. But this is like a little shaved ice booth, and this is a magician booth. I really love that it does that. And this is just like a random little sitting area. I really like how the pillows look on this. It's so cute. Okay, I'm gonna go up here and show you my Nook Bucks. Oh my gosh, Flick's over here. Sup, buddy? I don't think he interacts with any of your stuff, but I don't catch villagers here often either. Move, Flick. But I really like it. I've discovered that if you set out a microphone, I don't know if it has to be near a radio, but if you set out a microphone, your villagers will sing at the microphone. Next, I'm gonna show you my waterfall area, which I love. I also forgot to mention that I have a bike area. Sick as heck. Very proud of it. It's a parking area, also made by the person who made the moon wave design. And then I put this little gas thing, which I'm proud of for no reason. I know bikes don't need gas, but I think it's funny. I'll show you my waterfall area after I show you my little DIY area, which I can clean up now because you can officially put DIYs in your storage. But a lot of people have a free DIY area. So these are my free DIYs. This is where they used to be. And I would like block it off with this sign if I didn't want them to touch it. But now that's not a thing. And now I can just put them in my storage if I don't want anybody to touch my DIYs. Anyway, back to my waterfall area. This is my favorite part of my island. This and the part it leads up to, which is like a zen area. But to get the full effect, I'm just gonna walk down it for you guys. The waterfall sound effect is my favorite. Yeah. Oh my gosh, Audie. Audie's hanging out in my waterfall area. Makes me so happy. She's eating a donut. It hasn't been a year. I've just been time traveling. She's so cute. Audie is my, I think, peppy villager. I'm not sure. And worrying me is an offense punishable by hanging out with me. She's so cute. Oh, I just heard one of my villagers say hi to another villager. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I love that they enjoy the little area that I set out. Makes me so happy. This is my zen area. I put a grave here. I just think it looks cool. It's like all my stone themed stuff is over here. And then I'll go over here. I catch them in my orchard a lot. Hey Kabuki. Yeah, my island is full of... I wish I could see him. Hello. Kabuki also calls me comrade. I'm really excited for the day when all of my villagers call me comrade. Well, great. Now I'm seeing ghosts. Suppose it was only a matter of time, comrade. Hang on now. Your youthful vigor seems awfully familiar. Oh, Lex. I love the facial expressions they make when they're talking to me. It's so cute. Well, ain't you a sight? You were gone so long, we didn't know what to think. Welcome back. So cute. I really love the way weeds look in the fall. It's my favorite look. This is my orchard. Which I think I'm gonna get rid of in favor of a farm. Because I accidentally cleaned up one of my trees when I was trying to see if the island cleanup would clean up weeds. This is my bell farm. It's when I'm grinding for bells, I just put them over here. And then if I have somebody coming over, I'll just block it off with the wood fencing. And this is Kabuki's house. I like the art I did for him. I'm proud of it. And this is where she lives, I think. Yeah. This is Lolly's house. Lolly is new. Lopez used to live here, but I kicked him out. Say hi to Lolly. Wow, Lex, it's been, what, 1 year? Yeah. I've been spending my days taking long naps, hoping that I'd see you again. Enough about me, though. I'm just glad you're back, Bon Bon. I think your catchphrase is pretty cute. But, I need to stop saying, but, Oh, this chair. It's Chairman Mao. Get it? Because it's a chair. And he's a chairman. I'm so funny. I love this little, this greenhouse makes me so happy. It makes me so happy. Oh, so excited. Yeah. The thing about being in the Animal Crossing community is that you freak out over the littlest stuff. Like, we are a community of bare minimum ass bitches, and I can admit that. Anyway, I was time traveling a lot, and I ended up dumping them here because I was lazy. Oh, I was also moving a bunch of flowers that I left here. Also, out of laziness. But here's like my little recreational exercise area. I'm always very proud when I catch them like working out in this area. I've literally done none of the 2.0 stuff because I wanted to do it in a video, but I got sick because of the COVID booster vaccine shot. And absolutely go get your booster shot, but it took me out. It really did. Knocked me down all of the pegs. I was laying in bed, just like my wife was taking care of me for a solid 2 days. I was like weak, my body was so weak, and I was like cold. I was so cold. I was shivering in bed. Traumatizing experience, but it wasn't that bad. I got over it pretty quickly. It only took a day, but after that, I never found my motivation again until today. So, it took me a week to, but that's not the COVID vaccine's fault. That's my ADHD's fault. Hey. Oh no, Kyle can't play guitar. I gave him this bed because I thought he would replace his stupid cardboard bed with it, and he didn't, so now I hate him. But yeah, I hate Kyle's house the most. Marshall's not home. Audie's also probably not home. I know you can look to see if the window's open now, but I used to think it was just a smokestack that showed if they were home. So always look up, even though I could just look through the window. Anyway, this is where most of my villagers' homes are. It was kind of a pain to get the placement right. Like, I'll show you my map. They are semi-perfectly aligned, except for 3 of my villagers' houses, which are kind of dispersed randomly. But I really like this neighborhood type setup. I think that I would rather live in a neighborhood than just all on my own in the middle of nowhere. I'm also scared I'd get murdered, but that's just me. Silly old Lex. Try not to get murdered. You know how it is. This is my Abel's. It's not super cute. Nothing to flex. I do like this little area. I haven't done anything with my beaches. I don't really like Freya. Like, she's cute. She's snooty. I love that for her, but I guess I'll go talk to her. Oh my Lex, how are you? It feels like forever since we've spoken like this. Oh dear, I can't remember what sort of things we used to talk about. If you stayed away any longer, I might have forgotten you completely. That hurts my feelings. That was just a little joke, darling. You came back, so all is well. Welcome home, Lex. I gave her that cute little sweater. I'm proud of it. I need to stop just giving villagers gifts that are the same color as their fur. Because I think about how weird that would be in real life if people just gave me gifts because I'm brown. I think you're supposed to like you can look up whatever their favorite color is and get them clothes according to that. I think if they don't like the color, they won't wear it. I'm not sure, but it could be, you know? I really like this spot just because I used one of those patterns. Patterns are new with the 2.0 update. Ooh, hello. And I want to make all of my beds look like that. Da-da-da-da. Oh, this I made for my wife. Really excited about it because it took me so long to get all of these. If you haven't noticed, Bubblegum KK is my favorite. Oh, you can change the volume. I didn't know that. Oh my god. You can change the volume. That's life changing. It's not. But yeah, I made this right across from my wife's house because my wife really loves plants. And they got me into plants. So yeah. This garden wagon, I had to trade for a lot of flowers to get it. And this bench too. I had the DIY, but I didn't have like the bonsai stuff. But yeah. This is my wife's spot that I made for her. And then the last area, my campsite. I'm semi-proud of this. I like this little, like the fried, or not fried, the dried octopus thing. Which I got from CJ as a reward from the fishing competition, I think. But yeah, now that I've seen the 2.0 items, I think my campsite would really benefit from having some of those. So I'm excited to revamp my campsite, but it's alright the way it is now. Anyway, that is the tour. Oh gosh, I got trapped behind my pipe. That's not good. That's not good at all. Please, I don't. So yeah, we're gonna finish out this tour by giving you the tour of my house. And then maybe I'll show my island entrance real quick. So we're not finishing. I'm gonna show you my island entrance. I have roaches. But this is my communism themed little living room. I have icons of communism on my wall, which is all of my villagers because they live on communism. That's my like workout room. Exercise is really important to me. I was a weightlifter in high school. Not to flex, state champ, but you know, no big deal. this is my kitchen. I'm not super proud of it, to be honest with you. I don't have a great catalog of a furniture here. Like of kitchen furniture. But oh no. Okay, that's fine. It's Julian. Hey, if you're there, could you answer me? Yeah, I'll come and get you, Julian. So I have this dickhead neighbor who, just, like, revs their engine in the parking lot. And he does this at 9 a.m. Like, literally 9 a.m. Julian's here. Yeah, I have too many smug villagers. So, I guess I'll show you who I have. I have Julian, who is smug. I have Raymond, also smug. Kyle, smug. Marshall, also smug. But I really love Marshall, and I just got Raymond. Somebody gave him to me for free, which is amazing. I compensated them for it anyway. I just gave them some free stuff because I thought it was really cool. Yep, there's a dickhead neighbor. Anyway. Wow, he's such a douche. I hate him. And they... Oh, God. Anyway. There's no reason for that. There's just no reason. Anyway, I want to kick Kyle. And, possibly Freya. Because I'm not a huge fan of her. I liked her because I thought she was Russian. And that fits very well with my communism theme. But apparently, she's not. I think it's German. I think she's German. Anyway. So, Julian, I love him because he gives me very trans vibes. He's definitely queer. But I don't know. Too many dudes on my island, first of all. And, I'm tired of all the smug villagers. I don't need to have the same conversation 4 times a day. So, I really want a lazy villager. And I think I have Lolly as a normal villager. Apparently, in Japanese, they call normal villagers, sweet. And I think that's a much better descriptor than normal. Because I don't even know what normal means. Like, I literally have no idea what that means for, like, the personality type of the villager. But I did have a normal villager, and she was very sweet. So, I don't know. It just makes more sense to me. I saw a tweet about it today, actually. I don't know. All I know is I want Julian gone, and I want Kyle gone, and I want Freya gone, but I want Julian gone the least. Like, I like him, and I'll be sad to see him go, but the number of smug villagers on my island has reached a breaking point, and I'm sick of it. I don't want to have the same conversation 4 times a day. I just can't handle it anymore. Alright, see you later, Julian. I feel like I was just talking about him behind his back. I was. But it's fine. But yeah, I think it's really funny that if a villager comes over, and they just invite themselves over, as you do when you go to their house, which I think is hilarious, because, like, I think I would be annoyed too if somebody just showed up at my house and just walked around and touched my furniture. But they put up with it, and I guess now we have to too. But yeah. I think it's really funny that if a villager comes over and you have roaches in your house, or at least in the one room that they come to, then they will leave. They'll call you disgusting, but, like, they won't say it, but they'll think it, you know? Like, they'll, like, in a roundabout way, call you gross, and then just say they have to leave with some lame excuse. It's not lame, it's a funny excuse. But still. This is my bedroom. I really like customizable furniture that you can do funny stuff like this with. No, I don't want to sleep. I don't actually have a dream address set up, I think. Maybe I do. But it's really outdated. Anyway. Well, I have a cat, so I have a little cat tree. That's why my partner has one in their house, too. We gonna rob you. We gonna take your face off. I've been watching a lot of TikToks. And it got me really into some of the music from popular sounds. And what really got me out of bed this morning was my wife sent me this TikTok that has the Rock song where he's rapping. I don't know what it's called, but it's lit. We gonna take your face off. It's about drive, it's about power. We stay hungry, we devour. Put in the work, put in the hours, and take what's ours. Anyway, it's my jam, I love it. It's really motivational. Which I feel like is The Rock's thing. This is my chill bathroom. I don't know why we make bathrooms in our house, but it's fun. It's nice. I feel like I don't have great room themes. I just kind of built whatever. And I have one more room upstairs. Yeah, I haven't paid off my whole house yet, so I don't have the basement I still owe Tom and Nook the big bucks. It's like 1.2 million. And luckily, I have a sugar daddy coming who. They give me bells, not real money, but I have somebody who's gonna help me pay off that loan. Really excited about it. They're really cute too. No homo. But yeah, there's a lot of really cool people in the Animal Crossing community who will pay your house loan and hang out and send you letters. And it's just like really nice to have such a positive community. Because a lot of Twitter communities are toxic. Because it's Twitter. And I feel like the Animal Crossing community just isn't like that. The ASMR community and the Animal Crossing community are all really chill. Alright, that's the end of the tour. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. Bye!